This is Minimalish. I'm your host, Desiree, and before we get started, let me be clear. This podcast isn't just about minimalism. It's a podcast about living fully. Over the past few years, I've learned that living with a little less in our homes and on our calendars leads to less cluttering up our minds, which simply helps give us the space to give our time and thoughts to the things that actually matter. So what do we talk about on here? We talk about minimalism and decluttering and how to get there, yes. But we also have conversations about pursuing intentionality in the things that matter, like our motherhood, faith, relationships, work, and mindset. Minimalish is a podcast for the women committed to contentment and loving the life in front of them, committed to living with a little less so they can create space for the things that matter most. What it's not about, how many spoons you should have, or any kind of rules or legalistic minimalism that promises you'll be happier if you just get rid of more stuff. Getting rid of stuff isn't what will make you happy. It's about the life you live with the new space you find. If that sounds good to you, grab a mug of whatever you like and stick around. I'm so grateful you're here. Hey friends, so welcome to a special bonus episode of Minimalish. I was going to put this out as an intro to my KonMari Method episode, which is coming out tomorrow. I know that as someone who has a platform where I can share things and comment on things happening in the world, that I really need to share something about what's happening in the world right now with COVID-19 or coronavirus or whatever we want to call it. I was going to put this just briefly in the intro of tomorrow's episode, but that episode stands on its own and it is so good, and I don't want it to be forever captured in time with this weird intro talking about quarantine and social distancing. So I decided not to do that because, I don't know, 5 months down the road, hopefully we're not still in the same situation. I don't want someone scrolling through the podcast and having to think about this time in history. So I decided to put it out as its own bonus episode. And when I thought of talking about this, I didn't know what I wanted to say. I mean, I'm definitely not an expert in any way, shape, or form. So this is really honestly just stream of consciousness thought. And I think I just need to approach this. We have to talk about this. Everyone is talking about this. This is something serious. It's something that is affecting all of us. Our lives look very different than it did a week ago. So I can't just go on with the podcast and not say anything about it. So these are just some thoughts. And more than anything, I hope they just make you feel less alone. So just to be clear, I'm coming from the stance of someone who doesn't know everything about what's happening right now. I am not following every update on the news, first of all, because that will send me into overdrive and extreme anxiety. I am not an expert in anything dealing with what you should do in reaction, and I don't want to tell you what to do because I don't have all the answers. So that's definitely not what I'm doing. Instead, I decided I just want to share openly about how I'm dealing with this, because I thought if I could just use my platform for that, to just be honest and open and real with you, which is repeatedly the number one thing that I hear from you all, that you love this podcast because of the realness and transparency of it. So I'm going to continue doing that right here and now. So this kind of thing can really bring out a lot of anxiousness in me. I have anxiety and OCD, and it really revolves around sickness and disease of any form. So yeah, this has the power to really take me out. I've been struggling personally because I know our situation is good as a family. My husband is home because he's a teacher and I'm normally home. So our routine, while it is definitely not as it is usually, I'm used to being home. I enjoy being home. I am an introvert. Like, I'm happy to stay home. But the point is, it's not just about being home or staying home or having a routine issue. It's more about the fact that, you know, this is serious stuff and I don't know how serious. And, you know, some sources tell us one thing while other sources tell us another. People say don't panic. Other people are basically telling us to panic. It's hard to know how to feel. And I think that has been the biggest issue for me. While my husband is home, I am hoping to get a lot more work done and to be able to do the work that I enjoy. And we both have lists of things that we would like to do with our time, and we want to use it intentionally. But I'm not going to lie, I have been struggling because my mind is not in a normal place. My mind is not just present on the things that I'm doing as I aim for it to be in my normal everyday. My mind is elsewhere. My mind is just not sure how to feel. I go back and forth from feeling really anxious to feeling like, okay, we're all going to be okay. I don't know what the right thing to feel is, to be honest. I don't know what the right actions to take are. We are just trying to listen to government mandated things as much as we possibly can. With all of that said, I do want to just offer some thoughts after being on social media way more than I need to be and way more than I should be over the past couple of days. When I feel panicked about something, I often have this feeling that I want to consume as much information as possible on it to try to, I don't know, figure it out for myself. So that's what I've been doing, but it is not healthy for me to do that. It's what I'm trying to put a stop to right now, but this is just what I'm struggling with. So doing so, I have found that there's just a lot of shaming going on right now. There's a lot of telling people how they should react or what they should do. And I think it comes from a good place for most of us, but I just want to offer the thought of doing whatever we can to be kind, putting our energy into connecting with and checking up on the people that we are close to most of all. Because this is a time where we need our friends, we need our family, we need our actual community, and we might not be able to actually see them or be with them face to face. We need to be spending our screen time checking up on them, and that's something I keep reminding myself as I have this draw to consuming as much information as I can. I need to put my energy in a different place. Another thing I will share is just some things that I'm going to hopefully use this time for. And I wrote an Instagram post on this yesterday, but I'll just read you the post and then I'll read you the list, and hopefully it will be helpful to you. I said, this is all scary, confusing, strange. There's a lot of emotions. Situations are extremely different from person to person. But if we have our health, let's do our best to choose gratitude. If we have extra time, let's use it for good and maybe some rest. Even if from afar, let's remember that we have one another and let's check in on the people that we love. If you're stuck at home, maybe with more people in your house all at once than usual, maybe alone, take this time to do your best to look around at what you do have and count it as enough. We can take this time to grumble and worry, or we can take this time to do things that we've been saying we don't have time for. We can help others with what we can. We can keep in touch without touching. We can make do with what we have. We can take care of ourselves, and we can take care of others. We can pray for those whose situation might be tougher than ours and actually take action where we can. Maybe you're stuck at home, or maybe you're just stuck at work and then you have to go straight home more than usual. If there's nothing else that we have right now, we probably have more time. So we're less busy. Let's take a chance to live in that and to remember that life can happen when we're still too. These are some things that I'll be hoping to do in my margins instead of scrolling or binge watching, which ultimately makes me less happy and less content. I made them less specific in this list that I'm sharing with you right now so that maybe you can take some of them for yourself. And here's the list. Create something. Declutter something. Organize something. Move a lot. Eat as healthfully as possible. Pray. Read. Learn something new. Reevaluate a system. Give what you can. Gratitude. Lots of it. Spend time together, even if apart. So FaceTiming family and friends. I personally, on my list, just to give you some actual tangible things that I'm doing, I'm trying to walk at least 2 miles every day with my dog. I am going to try to edit all of the guest episodes that I have already done but haven't edited yet. I am trying to schedule some extra guest episodes that I wouldn't have time for normally now that I have a little bit of margin, and maybe others will as well have more space in their schedule. And I am trying to personally finish a course that I have purchased in the past. So I'm gonna go through a course and do some personal learning. So those are just some things I'm doing. I'm also trying to write 10,000 words for a book, but I'm doing my best. My mind is not in the best place for work. Like I said before, I'm struggling to be present but I'm doing the best that I can. And I think that overall, that's all we can do right now is to give ourselves grace and to do the best that we can. This list that I offer, or the idea of like quarantine bucket list or COVID-19 bucket list that people are putting out there, I don't think the purpose of these is so that we can check off all the boxes that we possibly can and be as productive as we possibly can in these next however many weeks this is our situation. I think the purpose is to keep ourselves living. That sounds bad, but I just mean to keep ourselves present, to keep ourselves accountable in a way to just doing life as best as we can with this new normal. It doesn't mean that you should feel bad if you had a day where you were mostly binge watching something or totally checked out or short tempered because you're dealing with a lot of anxiety. We can only do the best that we can. It's okay for this to feel hard. It's going to. That's all I have to offer. And I just wanted to put this out there. I don't know if it's helpful for you. It's really not anything super practical or step by step or anything like that. I don't have much to offer you. I don't know what the long-term effects of this all will be. I don't know how long this is all going to last, but you are all on my mind, and I am praying for this beautiful community. I am thinking of you, and I'm praying for you, and keep checking up on the people that you love. Keep in contact with people as much as you can, you know, not in person, digitally, however you can. Because it's not good to be isolated. I mean, we have to be right now, but it is not good to live in isolation, and that can be really dangerous. So don't allow yourself to get to that place, and don't allow the people you love to get to that place. With all of that said, I did just send out an email with some of my favorite at-home workouts and just some resources for decluttering in general, because this is a good time to maybe do those things. So if you're looking for a little resource on, you know, being stuck at home, you can get that at desireeandries.com/stuckathome. I did want to do something to help in some way, share whatever I can. So that is going to just be, that's an email that I sent out to my email list. So if you're not on the email list, you can get that email sent to you at desireeandries.com/stuckathome. Tomorrow is minimalish as usual, so don't miss my episode with Mandy from Among All of This. We are going to be talking the KonMari method. So if you are currently decluttering right now while you're home a little bit more, if you are home a little bit more and you decided you're going to take this time for decluttering, fun fact, it was around this time of year, 2 years ago, that my husband and I decluttered our entire house in a little over a week. So just saying, could happen for you. Maybe you're not able to get it out of your house right now, but if you are able to really go through and declutter and keep a holding room for all of your stuff until you're able to dump it off at Goodwill, I'm not sure that you'd be able to do that right now with the current situation. But if you want to do all of that, tomorrow's episode will be a really good resource for you to help you to do that. All right, friends, have a great rest of your day and stay healthy. I'm thinking of you, and I will talk to you right back here tomorrow.